5:30 at News Center 5 tonight. The first look at the book of a young woman, a young Wayland woman killed in a devastating crash, has been published posthumously. Marina Keegan was only 22 when she died 2 years ago. Her book is already number 2 on Amazon's bestseller list.
News Center 5's Janet Wu sat down with her parents today, who say publishing it stirred up heartbreaking and proud memories.
A few days after her 2012 graduation from Yale, Marina Keegan had a job waiting at The New Yorker, a play about to be produced, and a piece published in the Yale Daily News titled The Opposite of Loneliness.
We don't have a word for the opposite of loneliness, but if we did, I could say it's what I want in life. It's not quite love, and it's not quite community. It's just this feeling that there are people, an abundance of people, who are in this together.
That essay went viral after Marina died in a car crash when her boyfriend, who was driving her to the Cape, fell asleep. Her friends gathered for a memorial to a young talent who stirred a national debate about whether her generation should seek money or meaning. Here she is performing one of her poems at Yale, and now a book, including many other writings, is being praised for its literary quality.
She won't get a chance to know that people are reading her work, but I'm happy that her work will be read. And she would definitely want us to say, please don't read my work because I'm dead. Please read my work because I'm good.
Kevin Keegan said the international rave reviews make it all the more heart-wrenching.
There's no more work that she can produce, certainly, and that's unfortunate.
That's heartbreaking.
It really is.
It's just heartbreaking. I just feel like there was so much more she had to teach us, and we'll just never have the chance of hearing what that is.
The Keegans say the response to this book has been simply astounding. Thousands and thousands of readers have reached out to say how it has changed their lives. Tracy Keegan calls it the pieces of light in the darkness. In Wayland, Janet Wu, WCVB, News Center 5.